My dear, beloved, respected brothers and sisters, may Allah make me and you from the people who will benefit from these reminders. In our daily life, we go through ups and downs. Sometimes we have some great days, and sometimes we have some sad days. When we are going through times of sadness, stress, grief, or even depression, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us some du'as that we can say, and with the help of Allah azza wa jal, we will get the relief. All these du'as are authentic, taught to us by our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we take them and we have so much confidence, because they are coming from the one who only tells the truth, from the one who loves us so much, from the one who taught us everything about our deen. So there, I will mention five today inshallah ta'ala, and we will start with this hadith, which is in Abi Dawood. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the dua of the person who is in distress is Allahumma rahmataka arju fala takilni ila nafsi طرفة عين وأصلح لي شأني كله لا إله إلا أنت. الله أكبر. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that the dua for the distressed is, O Allah, I hope for your mercy. So do not leave me in charge of my affairs even for a blink of an eye. And Ya Allah, rectify all my affairs. There is no ilah except you. Subhanallah. I am begging for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am admitting the tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am showing my humility to Allah, my dire need, by saying that I am weak, Ya Allah. I cannot even take any simple decision. The best decisions only come from you. So the dua is, Allahumma rahmataka arju, fala takilni ila nafsi tarfata ayn, وأصلح لي شأني كله لا إله إلا أنت. Fix all my affairs. That's the first dua, inshallah, when you are going through stress. Second dua, and that is in Sahih Muslim and narrated by Ibn Abbas radiallahu an. And he said that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say that when he is sad. لا إله إلا الله العظيم الحليم. لا إله إلا الله رب العرش العظيم. لا إله إلا الله رب السماوات ورب الأرض ورب العرش الكريم. سبحان الله. The statement of Tawheed is all over this dua. لا إله إلا الله العظيم الحليم. We all know what لا إله إلا الله means. And the عظيم, he is the almighty, the all forbearing, الحليم. And then لا إله إلا الله رب العرش العظيم. لا إله إلا الله the Lord of the mighty throne. And لا إله إلا الله the رب of the heavens and the رب of the earth and the رب of the noble throne. رب العرش العظيم one time, and in the second one رب العرش الكريم. Somebody might say, where is the dua here? There's nothing here that says Allahumma, Ya Allah. No, the duas are divided into either praise or request. Here you are praising Allah. Ya Allah, there's no ilah except you. You are the Halim, you are the Azim, you are the رب العرش الكريم. You're praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah already knows what you want. Allahu Akbar. So this is the second dua. The third dua is very special. It's a little bit long, and I really, really recommend that you please take some time and memorize it. But why is so special about this dua? Because at the end of the dua, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, yes, indeed, whomsoever hear this dua should learn it. At the end of the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, whomsoever hears this dua should learn it. So now you are hearing the dua, please make the intention to learn it. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that no person suffers any anxiety or grief, and then he says this dua, Allahumma inni abduk wa ibn abdik wa ibn amatik nasiyati biyadik ماض في حكمك، عدل في قضاؤك، أسألك بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك، أن تجعل القرآن ربيع قلبي ونور صدري وجلاء حزني وذهاب همي. يا الله، how beautiful is this دعاء. يا الله، I am your slave, the son of your male slave, the son of your female slave. My forelock is in your hands. Your command over me is forever executed. And your decree over me is 100% just. I ask you by every name belonging to you, which you named yourself, or revealed in your book, or you taught to any of your ibad, of your creation, or you have preserved in the knowledge of the unseen with you. No one knows that name, because the names of Allah, the attributes of Allah, are not limited to 99. So I'm asking Allah Azza wa Jal with every name possible, the names that we know and the names we do not even know that are only known to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib, when we ask that, you would expect, you know, after all this introduction, after all this praise, you would say, Ya Allah, relieve my stress, right? No, subhanallah. After this beautiful introduction, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, Ya Allah, make the Quran the life of my heart. Make the Quran the light of my chest. And make the Quran the departure of my sorrow and release of my anxiety. Ya Allah, that shows us the importance of the Quran, Ya Akhwan. When we have a strong relationship with the Quran, subhanallah, Allah told us that أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. With the remembrance of Allah, the hearts will feel at ease. So one of the tools that when we are going through stress, open this Quran and read the words of Allah Azza wa Jal. If you can read them with explanation, with tafsir, that will be great. That will make you feel that I am reading those blessed words where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. Allah said that in the Quran, in these words, there is shifa, there is cure. So please try to memorize this dua. I know it's a little bit long. Take one, divide it into 4 or 5 parts and memorize one part every 2-3 days. But make a promise that, Ya Allah, by the end of this month, by the end of this year, whatever, I will be finished with this dua. Because Rasulullah ﷺ, at the end of the dua, he said, whomsoever hears this dua should learn it. And after he said this dua, he said, Allah will take away his sorrow and grief and give him joy instead. He said, whomsoever say this dua, Allah will switch his sadness and grief into joy. Tayyib. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had promised us that. I would say this dua with that in the back of my mind, that my stress will be switched into joy with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So try to memorize this dua. Number 4. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, shall I not teach you some words to say when you are feeling distressed? Yes, Ya Rasulullah. He said, say, Allah, Allah, Rabbi, la ushriku bihi shay'a. Allah, Allah, Rabbi, la ushriku bihi shay'a. Allah, Allah is my Lord, is my Rabb. I do not associate any partners or anything with Him. Very simple dua taught to us by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's 4. And the 5th one is, subhanallah, Ubay ibn Ka'b radiyallahu anhu. We all know the hadith. He came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I want to make a supplication for you. I want to make any salat upon you. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. A lot. Should I make it quarter? He said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's good. But if you do more, that will be better. Then he said, then I will make it half. He said, that's great. But if you make it more, then it will be better. So then Ubay said, Ya Rasulullah, I will make all my supplications for you. Yani, that does not mean that Ubay is not going to make any dua for himself. No. He said, like, for example, he dedicated that this half an hour, I'm going to make dua. So he decided to make this whole half an hour just salat on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the whole time. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, if you do that, if you make all that time that you dedicated for dua, you made it all for me, then what happens? Then your worries will be taken care of and your sins will be forgiven. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. This is the best form of salat in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But I can say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. That's all great also. So salat on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will also relieve our stress, and you do it abundantly on the night and the day of Friday like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam requested. Few things before I end inshallah. Many people think that if they are depressed, that means that their iman is weak, they are not good Muslim. This is wrong. Absolutely, faith and iman will definitely help when we are stressed or depressed. Definitely it will help. But does that mean if I am depressed, I'm not a good mu'min? No. There might be situations where you have some chemical imbalance and you need professional help. And there's nothing wrong with that. Okay? So alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we will seek and we will take all these du'as. And if we reach the point that we need professional help, we should please go and seek that also. This is what our deen taught us. And finally, my brothers and sisters, if you live with somebody who's going through stress or depressed, please, please remember that the depression keeps telling that person, you are worthless, you are ugly, you are not religious enough, you're not good enough. They keep putting them down, and you are there to provide for them support. Be patient. Be patient, support them, remind them of these du'as, remind them of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remind them that Allah is aware of everything that they're going, and Allah can change their status in a fraction of a second. Be there for them. Sometimes they might say things that, because they do not, maybe you're not aware what they're saying. Please be patient and support them insha'Allah ta'ala, and Allah will send you somebody who will support you when you are in need. So these are few du'as that will help us when we are stressed, inshallah. May Allah relieve us all from all kinds of stress. May Allah relieve all Muslims all over the world from any kind of stress. May Allah fill all our homes with love and mercy and tranquility and peace of mind. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, I ask you with the best of your names for everyone who's watching me right now, and their parents and their children and their loved ones, to fill their home with love and peace of mind. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.